Hi guys, it's me, Jimmy again. Today I'm gonna read a book by John Duckett. It's called JavaScript and jQuery. This is the book. Why the goodness of heaven I'm reviewing this book? Because I have read many JavaScript, and especially for the jQuery book. I mean, first I get started learning jQuery, then I learned JavaScript, and it was a big mistake. JavaScript, jQuery is a framework of JavaScript which really make easy, I mean, basically running animation on your website, but I didn't grasp the fundamental of function, how to do every kind of that kind of stuff. So I bought a lot of books, I mean, over the years, and indeed, yes, I improved my JavaScript skills, but this is one of the books that basically forced me to understand visually. I'm a JavaScript only, I basically only sometimes watch videos, sometimes I read a plain text, but this book is very visually colorful. I mean, it makes JavaScript code really alive. I am not praising this book, I'm telling you the reality. I mean, if you are totally new, being beginner, want to learn JavaScript, but you really think that JavaScript is hard, I mean, a lot of people start, I mean, becoming web developers, so they learn HTML, CSS, and then JavaScript. So JavaScript is always their first programming language. Whenever there is something like your first programming language, you get scared from the if loop, while loop, I mean, function, break statement. And then nowadays even JavaScript is having OOP, object oriented programming, where class and subclass or the parent and child is defined. But this is one of the best. This book will teach you how to use the Google API, Google Map, AngularJS. I mean, this is the masterpiece of any book. Not only that, if you don't know, today JavaScript is even running on electronic device. I was one of the computer engineering major, I mean, back in 2012, and then I dropped out. So at that time we can only use C programming language for any kind of real computer or any kind of microcontroller working, I mean. But now you can even use JavaScript in your breadboard, in your microcontroller, or of the whatever the project, your mini project you're building. JavaScript is becoming a beast. I wouldn't be surprised that JavaScript will be, I mean, the most famous language currently. The famous language Java, and then C++. Remember one thing, Java is not JavaScript. Java is freaking hard to learn compared to JavaScript. So I mean, this book is really awesome. I mean, it can be just your reference on your desk. I mean, for example, if you want to use some kind of, I mean, Google Map custom control, you can just flip the page, just basically see what it's going. It's clearly visual. I mean, to be honest with you, I like plain textbooks. I mean, black and white, it give me a feeling that I'm a real coder. But this book is really, to be honest with you, also now it even have a full section of debugging. Debugging is one of the major thing you should learn in programming. A lot of people wanna skip the debugging. Debugging is when it's a bug, how to fix a bug. Sometimes there are bugs which do not give you an error, but when you launch your application or your website, suddenly if some hacker or some figure out that bug, he can bring your website down. If your website is having any kind of exchange, in money exchange, financial or whatever, for example, you're selling like e-commerce, and then you have a small bug in JavaScript, you didn't notice, even you, I mean, try to run, you didn't find any error, but there's a bug, then you should do the debugging. And then I mean, it will tell you how I mean, for example, if you have basically make some kind of function, how it basically it go from state 1 to state 2. I strongly recommend this book. Basically, I strongly recommend. I will say go and buy, I mean, the set. I mean, the set will be cheaper. You will get HTML, CSS. I already reviewed this book, and currently I have finished reading this whole book, and then I'm gonna make a tutorial of JavaScript and jQuery based on this book. So basically, check it out. Basically, I strongly recommend. I mean, you can get a set if you think you already HTML, CSS in that, then it's okay. Don't buy this book. Go and buy this book. After reading this book, then I will say go and buy the Head First JavaScript. That book is really awesome, but it go in more depth. I mean, if you're totally new, Head First book can be a little bit hard for you. It's not hard. Head First as a concept that anyone can learn, but it's a little bit hard. Subscribe to my channel. It's me, Jimmy Agik. Bye bye.